Hey guys, welcome back to Genealogy and Chronology. Today we will be discussing about the complete genealogical history of the Western Chalukya dynasty, which ruled over present-day Telangana, Karnataka, Maharashtra, and parts of Andhra Pradesh states between 973 AD and 1200 AD. This chart is a part 5 of a 12-part series on the history of Telangana project by Genealogy and Chronology. Additionally, this chart is part 1 of a 4-part series on the Chalukyas of Deccan project by Genealogy and Chronology. Please consider subscribing to my channel as I will be discussing about genealogies and history of Indian royal houses in coming weeks. Let's move on to today's topic. The Western Chalukyas, who were also known as the Kalyani Chalukyas, were a branch of the Badami Chalukya Royal House. After the decline of the Badami Chalukyas in 753 AD, the Western Deccan fell under the Rashtrakuta dynasty. The Rashtrakuta dynasty ruled until 973 AD. During the rule of the Rashtrakutas, the princes of the Badami Chalukya dynasty served as subordinates to the Rashtrakutas and married into the Rashtrakuta Royal House and rose to prominence by late 10th century. In 973 AD, Chalukya Prince Tailapa II declared independence from the Rashtrakutas following the sack of the Rashtrakuta Capital by the Paramara dynasty. Tailapa II was the son of Vikramaditya IV. Vikramaditya IV was not just a male line descendant of the Badami Chalukya Royal House, but he was also a prince of the Rashtrakuta dynasty through his mother. After the sack of the capital city of Manyakheta by the Paramara dynasty, Tailapa II declared independence from the last Rashtrakuta king, Karka II. Tailapa II married a Rashtrakuta princess, and some historians believe she was the daughter of Karka II. I personally disagree with this fact as the generations do not match up. There is a possibility she was a granddaughter or from junior male branches of the family. The political landscape of the Deccan during the turn of the millennia was such that much of present-day Tamil Nadu was under the Cholas. The eastern coastal regions of peninsular India was under the rule of Vengi Chalukyas, who were distant cousins of Kalyani Chalukyas. Nonetheless, the Vengi Chalukyas sided with the Cholas and fought against the Kalyanis. In 997 AD, Tailapa II passed away and his son Satyasreya succeeded him. Satyasreya had a reign of only 11 years and in 1008 he passed away. He was succeeded by his nephew Vikramaditya V. Vikramaditya V also had a short reign of only 7 years and in 1015 he was followed by his brother Jayasimha II. Jayasimha's reign of 27 years is considered a largely peaceful one and overall progress of the Kalyanis. In 1042, Jayasimha II passed away and he was succeeded by his son Someshwara I. Someshwara I changed the capital of the Kalyanis from Manyakheta to Kalyani around the year 1050. It is from the capital city of Kalyani that the Western Chalukyan dynasty gets its name. Today, Kalyani is formally known as Basava Kalyan. After prolonged illness and loss to Cholas in war, Someshwara I committed ritual suicide on the banks of River Tungabhadra in 1068. His son Someshwara II became king. In 1076, a brief civil war engulfed the Kalyanis. Someshwara II was dethroned by his younger brother Vikramaditya VI, who would go on to become the most famous Kalyani Chalukya king. Vikramaditya VI ruled for 50 years and the kingdom rose to its peak under him. At its peak, the Western Chalukyan kingdom stretched from River Narmada in north to River Kaveri in the south. In 1126, after reigning for 50 years, Vikramaditya VI died and he was succeeded by his son Someshwara III. Between the years 1126 and 1164, gradual decline of the Kalyani Chalukya started under Someshwara III, Jagadika Malla II and Tailapa III. Continued battles between the Cholas and the Kalyani Chalukyas resulted in both kingdoms declining in power. Vengi was already lost to the Cholas. This gave an opportunity for the Kakatiyas, who were their subordinates, to rise against their overlords and declare independence over much of present-day Telangana and Andhra in 1163. The Hoysalas then went on to annex much of present-day Karnataka into their empire. Tailapa III was killed by the Hoysalas in 1164 AD. Subsequently, the Yadava dynasty rebelled and declared independence over much of present-day Maharashtra. In 1200 AD, Jagadika Malla's third rule ended and he was succeeded by his son Someshwara IV, who possessed virtually no territory or power. The vastly diminished Kalyani Chalukya kingdom was divided between the Hoysalas and Suvenas, who are also known as the Yadava dynasty. Thus ended the rule of the Western Chalukyas over Deccan. The Wingi Chalukyas also lost their prominence around the same time, and soon the entire Telugu-speaking lands were under the Kakatiya dynasty. I hope you all like this complete overview of the royal house of the Western Chalukya dynasty. Next week, I will be going over the Eastern Chalukyas, and next month, I will be releasing the Rashtrakuta dynasty family tree, which is part 6 of the 12-part series in the history of Telangana project. Later in the month of May, I will be dropping the Badami Chalukya video, which is going to be part 7 of this series. You can watch the videos of the Asafjahi dynasty of Hyderabad, the Qutubshahi dynasty of Golconda, the Bahmani Sultanate of Deccan, and the Kakatiya dynasty that ruled Telangana after the Western Chalukyas by clicking on the playlist on my channel. Please consider liking the video and subscribing to my channel and share this video with your friends and family. If you want a printed copy of this chart and you live within India, please reach out to me. Please consider supporting me on Patreon by becoming a member, or you can buy me a coffee by scanning this code. Thank you.